Let's take a look at how primary keys work in ClickHouse. It's important to understand how they work because they're different than the primary keys you're used to in all those database systems where the primary key represents a unique row. In ClickHouse, the primary key represents the sort order of how your data is stored on the file system for your merge tree tables. And so in this simple example here, I have three columns, column one, column two, and column three. And for whatever reason, I picked column one and column two to be the primary key. And by the way, I could have replaced primary key with order by. The order by clause would have become the primary key. And so I'll put some rows in there. Notice that column one is either A or B and column two is either one or two. And it looks like I'm inserting eight different rows. If you were to look at the files inside the part folder that gets created for that insert, you could actually see that in column one, all the A's will be first and then all the B's. And really column one and column two together, it's all the A1s are first, then there's an A2, a couple of B1s, and then the B2s are last. So notice that that's how the data gets stored. So that third column follows along. So the strings are sorted by those primary key values. What's the purpose of this? Well, a primary index gets built off the primary key. So every merge tree table has a sort of built-in index. We call it the primary index because it's built off the primary key. And it's very simple, very straightforward how it works. The primary index contains the value of the primary key for every granule. And a granule is a logical way of looking at your tables, the rows inside your tables. And it's by default 8,192 rows. That's how big a granule is. And so inside the primary index, like A1, if that's the first value of the primary key, that would point to row one. Then the second value in the primary index is going to point to the 8,193rd row. So whatever the primary key of that row is, it looks like here in this diagram, it's A1 also. And then it looks like the third granule starts with 16,385. That must be A2. That is the third granule, and so on. It's why we call the primary index sparse, because it's only one entry for every granule. What's interesting about the granule is that's the smallest amount of data that ClickHouse processes. If you search for even a single row, it'll still process an entire granule. Now it's ridiculously fast, so it's not a big deal to search for one row. But just keep that in mind, that picking a good primary key helps you skip granules in your queries. So I'll show you a specific example. Here I have a table called Amazon Reviews, and it's in the documentation if you want to download that data set. It's about 150 million rows of actual product reviews from products sold on Amazon. And so you can see that it's a merge tree table, and for the primary key, I picked marketplace, review date, and product category. The assumption being that a lot of my queries probably filter by review date and or product category. If I write a query that doesn't filter off one of those values, then you'll see that it has to search every row. So first of all, let's see how many rows we have. There's 151 million rows, roughly. If I want to compute the average value of, let's say, this star rating column, and I'm going to filter by total votes greater than or equal to 1,000, well, total votes is not up here in the primary key. And so ClickHouse had to query all 151 million rows, roughly. If I filter on something like review date, notice review date is in the primary key. Well, here it was, first of all, way faster. And second of all, notice it only had to query this 3,883,008. Notice it's a it's exactly a multiple of 8,192. That's 474 granules that it had to process, as opposed to all 150 million rows. It only had to process 3.8 million rows. That's the beauty of the primary key. So your goal is to pick a good primary key. A good primary key contains the columns that you query by or filter on in your where clauses in your queries.